So that's what we're saying, that is the addition of the two side, and then you get your the service here back, your cylinder. Then I'm insisting on one thing, that if the cylinder is open, you know to multiply by two. In my case, if they are going to be told that the cylinder is open, don't multiply by two, just only find the area of only one circle. But again, if your toilet is open on both ends, don't include the first part, just only find the area of the cavity surface, which is given by 2 pi L. That is where it is hollow, meaning it is like a pipe. So now we move to the second part of the figure, and that one is going to be the surface area. That is the surface area of a pyramid. So here we are moving now to something which is known as a pyramid. Remember, you are dealing with a prism, and a prism we are saying is that figure which have the uniform cross-section. It has a uniform cross-section. So when we focus now on the case of the pyramid, we are saying the surface area of a pyramid is the sum of the area of the slanting faces and the area of the base. So meaning that a pyramid, it will have a point, it will have different points, slanting edges, that are going to be meeting at a common apex, and I'm going to show you how it is. So in this case, you just find the area of the base, then you find the area of the slanting edges, slanting faces which are mostly triangular, then you sum them for you to be able to get the surface area of the pyramid. Then from there, you can be able to see the diagram which I'm talking about. Check on this. This one is the pyramid. You can see it's the pyramid here. The base is up. The base is a square with 14 millimeter. Then you have that 14 millimeter. So meaning again, we have the slanting triangle. There, there's going to be one. The other one, two, three, four. So you have four of them. So in this case, this is the pyramid that we are talking about. So if we are trying to find the surface area of a pyramid, we are saying you will start with the base. So once you find the area of the base there, then again you continue. You find the surface area of one of the triangle here, then again you multiply by 4, and then you take the sum as is there on my slide there, as you can see. So the solution, surface area is going to be that of the base, so you get the base area plus the area of the 4 triangle. Remember, you have said that a base was a square, that's where you have 14 multiplied by 14, and that's when you are getting our answer as 196. Then from there we have now the triangle. We have it is a half base multiplied by height. Our base is 14. Then our height is also 14. Then we multiply by 4. That one we get 252. So if you try to take the sum of the two, that's what you're going to have. So this one is going to be addition of the two. That is 196, the area of the base, plus 252, the area of the triangle. So this one is going to give us, just from the calculator, that is 196 plus 252. So you get that answer is 448 centimeters. Last one, we talk about the case of the pyramid. Common base, then plus the other part of it, as you can see in that case. So, as we continue again, to give you another picture for that. So that's what we have, the slanting length. See, that is the slanting length here, from here to here, then you have the height. That is our picture of a pyramid, the way it is, which it looks like. So we are talking about the base, so it is the area of the base, then from there, that's the area of the sum of the references that are making it. So you have the example there, we have shown in the figure below. It's a right pyramid with a square base. You told the square base is 4 cm. Then you have the slanting edge is of 8 cm. Then you are told to find the area of the pyramid. The figure which you have been given is having a base, a square base, 4 cm. Then the slanting edge is 8 cm. Then you are told to find the area of that pyramid. So what are you supposed to be able to start with? You start with the area of the base. Remember, you're saying that the area of the base is going to be given by what? The area of the base is going to be given by The area of the base is going to be given by the area of that square. So that's what we have, side multiplied by side. Then from there, the other triangles are going to be 4, then a half, then this times height. So remember, the height is the slanting height. So we don't need, we need to use the Pythagoras theorem in order for us to be able to get that slanting height. That's what we are saying. If you divide the base by 2, so you're going to get here, that's going to be 4, then you have that height is 8, and then when you find the square root of the 60, that's when you're going to get the height which you're going to use at this height. So you don't use the original height which you have been given as 8. So in this case, 4 times 4 there, then plus a half times 4, then times the square root of the 60. So there if you work out from our calculator, you're going to have that is 4 times 4, that one gives us the area of the base is 16. Then plus now, the other 4 triangle, it is going to be a half, multiplied by 4, multiplied by root of 60. Then again multiplied by 4 triangles there. It is giving us 61.96. Then you carry out the addition of the two, that one is 16. Then that one give us 77. 77.97. So that's what we are talking about the case of the pyramid. So you decided to identify the base, then once you get the base, then you find the other slanting shapes, which are mostly triangle. Just apply the formula of the triangle, but identify the height that you're going to be using. The surface area of a cone, that's now going to be our next shape. So from the pyramid, we go to the cone. So in the case of the cone, we are saying that the total surface area of a cone is given by pi r squared plus pi r l, whereby the pi r l is the curved surface. And then a cone is a figure with a circular base. So I'm going to show you in this case. That's what I mean. So when you say that the formula is given by pi r squared, pi r squared plus pi r l. So this is what we are saying, this is the base. The base. So the base is a circle. Then this one is the curved surface. This one is the curved surface. You need to be able to understand. So you have the curved surface plus the base. So once you take the addition of the two, that's when you come up with the area of the cone. And in our case, you can look to see there you have been given the radius is 4 cm. Then again, you're given the slanting height. You're calling the slanting length is 5. So if you're trying to find the area of this pyramid, you just substitute this formula. So it's going to be 22 by 7, multiplied by our radius is 4, multiplied by 4. Again, plus 22 over 7, multiplied by our radius is 4. Then multiply by our slanting length, which is 5. So once you take the addition of the two, then you're going to get your answers as calculated in this slide here. So in this case, find the surface area of the cone above. You understand that it's what we are saying, 22 over 7, which is going to be 3.14. So you sum the two of them, so this one gives us what? When you press from the calculator, this one gives us 50.24, that is the area of the base, plus the area of the curved surface, which is saying this is 62.8 centimeters squared. This one is also centimeters squared. So when you carry the addition, you're getting the total. It is 113.04 centimeters squared. That's the how you find the area, the surface area of a cone. That is the going to be the area of the base, which is a circle. That's now the area of a curve, surface. And you're told that always, there's an NB there, always use the slanting height. If it is not given, then you have to find it using the Pythagoras theorem. So you don't confuse, and then you try to use this height. In this case, you don't use this height. So if I give you this height, then you have to apply the Pythagoras theorem to not get the slanting length. So you don't use this height. Then make sure that you use the slanting height, which you are going to be given. That's why the NB is saying that always use the slanting height. If it is not given, use the Pythagoras theorem in order for you to find it. From there, our next figure is going to be the surface area of a sphere. That one, I think, is going to be the last one. In this case, we are saying, we are starting with the definition of what is a sphere. I'm saying that a sphere is a solid that is entirely round with every point on the surface at equal distance from the center. That is the formula which is saying that the surface area is 4 pi r squared. So it's very different from the formula of a circle. So if this one is the formula for a sphere, which is 4 pi r squared, then for the hemisphere it's going to be half of it. In this case, that's how the sphere looks like. You can see every line moving there from the center, according to the radius. Then you have the great sphere there. That's what you talk about, the shape of a sphere. It's like that shape of a football, the shape of a soccer ball, the way it appears. Then from there we say, find the surface area of a sphere whose diameter is equal to 21. Then there the solution, just only to know the formula, which is going to be 4 pi r squared. Then you substitute there, then you're getting your answer as 1386. So as I conclude my lesson for today, I'm going to give you the exercise which you're going to tackle in your assignment book. That one is going to be on page 155 to page 176. So I'm going to give you some questions there. You have question 1A, you have question 4A, and then from there also have some 4A there, from there, you're going to do question number 6, question number 7, then from there, I think those are going to be enough for you. So make sure that you do that one, submit me to the WhatsApp for marking, then the next time I'm going to come and summarize with the volume. Otherwise, you have a good day. Thank you.